Prince Harry is coming across as petulant and can't pick and choose what perks of being a royal he wants to keep after stepping down, an expert has claimed amid the Duke threatening legal action on the Home Office. The Duke of Sussex and his wife Meghan Markle quit royal duties and moved to the US in 2020, where they currently still reside with their two children. However, now Harry has said he is unable to bring his family back to Britain because it is too dangerous without police protection. The prince lost his taxpayer-funded police security when he and Meghan stepped down as working members of the royal family. Now, he has pled for this security to be reinstated when he returns to British soil with his wife and their two children and has offered to foot the bill. The Duke has filed a claim for a judicial review against the Home Office decision not to allow him to personally pay for the security whilst in the UK. A statement released by a legal representative for the Sussexes explained the Duke's concern for his safety when visiting British soil. A statement from Harry's lawyers detailing the legal action read, "Prince Harry inherited a security risk at birth, for life. He remains sixth in line to the throne, served two tours of combat duty in Afghanistan, and in recent years his family has been subjected to well-documented neo-Nazi and extremist threats. But now royal expert Jenny Bond told OK that Harry is coming across as petulant by making threats to sue." She adds that the Duke can't have it both ways when it comes to wanting the privileges of being a member of the royal family despite stepping back from the firm. She said, "It's one thing to request security, but it's another to threaten to sue your grandmother's government. He comes across as petulant. Harry can't pick and choose like this, he can't have it both ways, and he's beginning to realize that having given up his royal duties, he's going to lose privileges which he thought were by birth his." While in the US, the couple pays for private security, and Ms. Bond went on to add that she doesn't know why this team in America can't provide sufficient security. She said, "I would have thought there was a lot less danger in the UK than the gun-toting American world he lives in now. You can't just hire Scotland Yard, they don't have officers sitting around, and I understand if it is required then it will be provided." However, a legal spokesperson said the Sussexes believed the UK threat level is particularly high, greater than that faced in the US, and that their US security cannot replicate the necessary police protection needed whilst in the UK. The government removed Harry and Meghan's UK police security following their decision to relocate to the States. The couple live in Montecito with two-year-old Archie and their daughter Lilibet, who celebrates her first birthday in June. Since moving across the pond, Harry and Meghan have never returned to the UK with their children in tow. Harry has returned to Britain on two occasions, firstly to attend the funeral of his grandfather Prince Philip in April last year, then to unveil a commemorative statue of his mother Princess Diana in July. The Duke's lawyer made reference to this last trip in their statement, saying that his vehicle was reportedly chased by photographers as he left a charity event. In a concluding paragraph of the statement, the spokesperson for the Sussexes adds, "The UK will always be Prince Harry's home and a country he wants his wife and children to be safe in. With the lack of police protection, comes too great a personal risk. Queen Elizabeth is in absolute despair at the actions of some of her closest family members, according to a royal expert. It looks like the Queen may have had a difficult start to the new year, and the behaviour of some of her children and grandchildren, namely Prince Andrew and Prince Harry, really isn't helping matters." Drew and Prince Harry.